First and 10 at the 11. They'll try and run right on the option. And this play goes nowhere, losing yardage back to the 15. So a step in the wrong direction. Now they'll look to make amends on 2nd and 14. Here's Jackson to throw. And he's got it. And in for the Ravens touchdown. Gabriel Davis, his second touchdown on the season. And the Ravens are on the board first here this afternoon.
This is a crew, they've come out flat their last two games, both losses, but just judging by the energy level, they look different here early, and that touchdown shows how.
Yeah, it seems to me that that touchdown gets them off the treadmill. Because, you know, you've been on the treadmill. I've seen you work out. You go forever and ever, and it tells you you've gone somewhere, but you really have. You're in the same spot. They've exchanged it for an escalator. Still got some hills to climb, but they can get there.
Those are good analogies. I run outside sometimes, though. You know, get some fresh air, a little sun on your face.
A little wind in there.
Yeah, that's right.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Jones and the Giants now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll start out on the ground. It's Saquon Barkley. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. What I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
From the 29, Jones. And that nearly an interception here on this opening drive, but he gets a reprieve. It's third down.
Charles, already trailing by touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid 3 and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
Now Jones. Oh, trying to fit it into Shepard, but it's intercepted. Kyle Hamilton picks it.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got 2 extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dime set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
After the interception, here's Jackson. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on 2nd and 16. Jackson going to give this one to Edwards. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. That one good for 17 yards, and now they've got it 1st and goal.
Hey, run.
They'll run here with Edwards. It'll be a pickup of 4, and it brings up 2nd and goal.
And Brandon, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line, because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines, as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. Second and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. Drake. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining.
we step aside here in this second quarter. The ball mere inches from the white line on third and goal. Jackson's going to try the sneak, trying to barrel up in there, but I don't think he got it. So call that no gain on the sneak, and now they're still a yard short here on fourth. Defense didn't budge on third down. Now what are we going to see on fourth?
We are soon to find out, but does this feel like old school football or what?
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
It's an old-fashioned goal line stand. I know what I would call on offense. I would go for it. I want some type of a play where my quarterback has a chance to run it or throw it. I don't just want one static play.
And he'll wind up being knocked back to the 3-yard line. They stop him up short on fourth and goal from the one. And this Giants defense able to come up with a goal line stand. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive.
And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, some guys, you know, they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to want to look to hit a couple shorter passes, get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
Big Calais Campbell fighting through to make the play in the backfield. So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. Jones fakes the give to Barkley. He's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A gain of 28 yards there and give him a first down. Jones with a handoff to Barkley. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. The Giants at a disappointing 1-4 as they start play. And they come into this one knowing it's been a while since they've had a W. They have dropped 4 in a row.
Let me tell you, when you go a month, partner, in this league, without a victory, it gets tough to come to work every day. And in addition, you start to wonder about your job security as well.
Buying time to his left. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
They've given him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit 2 of his first 5 passes. With a big third down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
They'll send a receiver in motion to the left. Throwing, Jones. And that's complete to Shepard. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. Throwing on first down, Jones completes this again to Shepard. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. He's been a one-man wrecking crew these last couple of plays. This time 18 more and a first down. Two minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. They'll try and run for it with Barkley. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one. Give him 4 on the carry there. It's second and goal.
As long as you've been the air attack, that's gotten him down here. But now is where you start to lean on that running game. That's a good pickup there on first and goal.
They'll try to run with Breida. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
them back at the three now. This is third and goal. Back to throw. Jones. That's to Galladay, and he's got it. Touchdown, New York. The three-yard touchdown pass, and the Giants go 98 yards and finish it off in the end zone. Extra point try, good by Galladay, and we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Duvernay now going to bring it out. The lane opens here. He's past the 30. Yeah, they'll have good field position here as he's out of bounds up at about the 34-yard line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
And that one's all about the defender making life difficult for the receiver. Very tough for a guy to hold on to the football through all that contact. He ends up forcing the incompletion.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now it's Jackson. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And the pressure gets to him again. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. So two sacks for the rookie, definitely making an impact here in year one.
And in a ton of different ways, because rushing the passer, that was supposed to be a skill that he was developing. Looks to me like he's figured it out already.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. On the return, Jackson. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And it'll be Giant football first and 10. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they've got a little over 40 seconds to work with if they want to try to put something together. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. Now a play fake here on first down. Escape, and he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. The Ravens going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. After the sack here, second and 11. Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's got Bellinger. And he goes out right around the 39. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. That close on third down, I think everybody probably expecting a run. Instead, they go to the air on third and short yardage.
I realize this is a passing league, and they're liable to throw the ball on any down and distance. But that short, I do question the call. Run the football and pick it up.
And this is caught, but they say out of bounds. That would have been a first down, but he couldn't stay in, and as a result, they're going to have to give up the football. So they take a big, big chance here in their own territory, and you think the coach may have some questions to answer?
Yeah, and, you know, normally we focus on the media, right, the social media barrage that he's going to get for this one. How about on his own sideline and in his locker room?
Touchdown! Rashad Bateman, as the first half is winding down. And the Ravens have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. So that pretty conclusively, I might add, shows you the perils of going for it and not making it on fourth down. One play, touchdown.
Yeah, and I've got to put this on the man in charge, the head coach. He made the decision to go for it. To me, when punting was the only decision to make, and it backfired on him in a big way.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And he goes down. The Ravens able to get to him. And now a timeout defensively after that first down play. So they're going to make this offense sweat out half number one. So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24. They don't want to repeat a first down. They'll keep it on the ground. And he'll just keep two hands on the football as he'll be taken down after a short pickup. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number three here. And how about this right out of the locker room? An onside kick attempt. Oh, the Ravens say they have it. They do have it. Set at the line for this next drive. And they got the lead. CD, what do you think the message was at halftime?
I don't think the message was too drastic, I think, at the half, or that they need to change things too much. I do think the offensive line could play a little bit better. I think they'll try and help them out more. They'll probably keep a tight end in a few more times and maybe add a running back to the formation to pick up those pass rushers, because they probably allowed a few too many sacks for comfort in the first half.
Edwards now on first and 10. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down about the 39. He was brought down there by Julian Love.
Oh, there's plenty of traffic waiting for him up the middle. But give him credit, he tried barreling through anyway. They're fortunate to get a yard out of that one.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Jackson. And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over at that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
First thought is surprise, because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Flushed out right. Dumps it off to Edwards. And he'll be brought down at the 34, well short of the first down marker. So Jackson will head to the Ravens sideline, and on comes Justin Tucker for the field goal try. On the right hash, officially this will be a 51-yard attempt. Tucker's kick is good, and they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. Well, they picked up right where they left off in the first half. First drive after the break, they come away with 3 and increase that lead.
Yeah, and you just want to keep building on that lead, don't you? Whether it's 6 points or 3 points, take everything you can get, keep maneuvering, keep adding to it, keep making it difficult for them to come back.
Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And their deficit a little wider now than it was at halftime following the field goal a moment ago.
But the goal is still the same because you know they want to come out, establish a rhythm in the second half, and get going. Make no mistake about it, though. Kicking field goals, not in their game plan. They need to get the ball in the end zone.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Looking to throw, Jones. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
On second and 10, Jones. Open target here, Darius Slayton. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards. They'll look to throw again. Out to the right here to Shepard. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Excellent play there on third down. Give him 25 yards. So in Raven territory now. Here's a first and 10 down at the 31. A give to Barkley out of the gun. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
On second and 11 now. Jones. Looking and finding Shepard on the crossing route. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. 25 yards that time. Out of the shotgun, they run with Barkley. And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5.
The yards may start getting a little tougher to come by down here near the goal line. That's good work defensively there on first down, holding them to a short gain.
And the ball smack dab on the 5 yard line. Here's second and goal. Another try for Barkley. And he takes it into the end zone for a Giant TD. Saquon Barkley, his third rushing touchdown of the year. And the Giants have cut it back within a score. Gano the extra point. And leads down to a field goal at 17-14. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Duvernay now going to bring it out. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Their lead down to a field goal now as they start with a first and 10. A quick throw, knocked away, and incomplete.
Partner, for once in my life, I'll be succinct. In a one-possession game, every single stop like that could be a difference maker.
A good action to this point in the third quarter. Just a 3-point game, second and 10. Now a throw downfield is taken in by his running back. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
You know, when we call a game, we talk about Lamar Jackson and his speed, his elusiveness, and the ability to get him on the ground, how tough that is for a defense. But how about his defense?
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Kayvon Thibodeau able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon. 3 quarters in the books. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Play action. It's Jackson. Unquench one for Davis. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. They set themselves behind the chains, trying to get it all back in one play, and it backfired.
Didn't it feel like a pitcher working his way into a 3-0 count, right? You're behind. What do your coaches always tell you? Get it back one pitch at a time. In this case, they tried to get it back right away, and it didn't work out.
They begin with a run by Barkley. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first. They held him in check in the first half, but that's his longest carry of the game right there.
So would this be the definition of fresh legs since he didn't get much done in the first half? Now he has a great opportunity. He's taking full advantage of it.
They keep it with Barkley on first down, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run. The best runs for the top running back, those are the ones you focus on and want to take away. And they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
From the 36, Jones. And his throw is incomplete.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes where people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Now Jones on third down. Oh, he rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Kyle Hamilton picks it. And the Ravens are going to take possession of the football. One side gets an interception, but their defense comes on the field and picks him right back up by getting a pick of their own.
And I think you saw the same thing that I did, Brandon. As he ran off the field after making that play, we saw his quarterback seek him out and offer a personal thank you to bail him out a little bit as the offense takes the field again.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. On second down, it's Edwards. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pick up a 3.
I have to laugh a little bit because he actually handed it off. I thought with the 2 touchdown passes he's thrown in this one already, he'd go ahead and fling and try and get a third one.
Yeah, now from this spot on third down, I think he'd probably throw it here.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question about it. They won't even send in a running play here, I don't believe. I think they'd go ahead and try and throw it for a touchdown.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. So decision time now, because a field goal keeps it a one-score game. What are you thinking?
Well, I'm looking at the down and distance, and that's where the issue comes in. It's not short enough that it's a no-brainer and you go for it. You have to analyze this one. To me, you take the field goal, take the points. I don't think you want to risk coming away with nothing.
They're going on third down. It's Jackson. That's to his running back, complete. And in for the Ravens touchdown. Gus Edwards, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Ravens are able to build on to their fourth quarter lead. Tucker now to add the point after. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Well, that last last touchdown we just saw. What an important one. Now it's back to a two-score deficit for this crew as they take the field here, and they are in desperate need of finding the end zone. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. This pass into the hands of Bellinger. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Off the play fake. Jones. Flush to his right. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
I'm not even sure I know who this guy is out there playing right now. This is very unlike him, one of the most accurate guys in the league. Totally off his game right now.
I don't know. I was going to ask you what you pin it on, but defensively, they've been pretty solid.
Well, sometimes, you know, those defenders, they get into the receivers pretty well, and if they chip away at their timing, it's going to affect what you're doing throwing the ball as well.
To throw again on second down, Jones. That's complete left side to Shepard. And he's going to be taken down with the first down at the Ravens 42. Off play action, Jones. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Tell you what, partner, after he ices down, he's going to be a nice long soak in a hot tub after this one. He's been under duress the entire game.
Yeah, once again, hit as he throws. Fortunate that one wound up incomplete. They'll bring a receiver in motion left. To throw once more on second and 10. Jones. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Roquan Smith, and the Ravens are going to take over at their own 41. Well, time, I mean, certainly not on their side offensively. They had to take some chances, but that interception will further hinder their already slim chance at victory.
Yeah, and you're talking about time not on their side, but it certainly was on the defensive side, and they understood that. They knew they had to press it a little bit, and they planned accordingly. And what a benefit for them, able to pick that one off and hopefully put this game away.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. They'll run the option left. And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. The Ravens on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 16. Jackson now. He's going to look deep for more. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
I usually hesitate when I say a guy's got world-class speed, but this guy might. So let's fire the starter's pistol. Let's go. If you've got him, you've got to try and use him. A lot of anticipation with the ball in the air, but no, incomplete.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. With it is Jackson. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. So it's Giants football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now Jones.
connects with Slayton.
And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Jones. Eluding the pressure right. He's going to let it fly. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
That means it's just one last chance left, and this has to be a first down or a touchdown, or this game's over.
Desperation time now. Here's Jones.
He'll buy some time right. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Ravens get the football back and in great shape. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They'll start by running the option to the right. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. You'd have to think likely another running play coming here, second and 11.
Jackson going to hold on to it again.
That's going to go down as a loss of 5, and it brings up third down.
Pretty good job there defensively of stringing that one out.
Yeah, you've got a quarterback who's waiting and waiting for something to develop, and it just never materialized, and down he went behind the line of scrimmage.
Here's Jackson. And this is going to be incomplete.
Now, the secondary's really struggled today, but that's a little bit of a measure of revenge, isn't it? And they just followed the basic rules. See ball, knock ball away. Turns into a nice play.
And I tell you what, he got it from 58. That had lots of leg behind it, and that will extend their lead even further. So they settle for just the 3, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the 4th.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but it's still 8 up time, got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And last time, went for it on 4th, didn't get it. We'll see if they can pick themselves up off the mat and do better this go around.
Sometimes I have this vision of coaches writing notes to themselves before a game, and sometimes that note says, be aggressive, stay aggressive. Maybe that's what we saw in the last possession.
Yeah, they were very aggressive. This time, will it result in points? We'll find out.
To throw is Jones.
They'll roll it, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call.
It always feels like good players fall to the Ravens on draft day. And David Ojabo was the latest example of a draft steal. Big time potential and had a breakout season 2021 in Michigan.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Ravens going to use their 3rd and final timeout. That'll be their 3rd and final stoppage here as we step aside. They'll go to Barkley again, and he'll take this for a short gain on what will prove to be the final play of this ball game. So the final seconds tick away in this Baltimore victory, and they were spurred on by a strong performance in that 4th quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game, but when you throw one in the 4th quarter, that tells everyone that you're getting stronger. And dominance is starting to take over, right? The way that you close, the way that you finish, that gets preached to you from the time you're playing Little League football all the way up through. And they closed them out with a big-time performance down the stretch.
Hello, new world, all the boys and girls. I got some true stories to tell. You're back outside, but they still lie. Whoa, yeah.
Take off the foo-foo. Take off the cloud chase, take off the Wi-Fi. Take off the coupon, take off the car loan, take off the flex and the white loss. Take off the weird security, I'ma take 10 steps, then I'm taking off top off. Take off off the fabricate streams and the microwave to the real world outside. Take off your idols, take off the runway, take off the Cairo, take off the Sandro pay, 5 days stay, take off for the meal, hella follow. Take off the far flare, take off reception, take off the cop with the iPad, take off the